Endometriosis is the menstrual tissue that escapes from the inside of the uterus, and it implants itself on the organs and tissue that's in the pelvis. And it's quite a debilitating and uncomfortable condition because it goes through monthly fluctuations with bleeding, just like a menstrual cycle might, but in places that it shouldn't be. I use the analogy of going to the beach and getting a little bit of sand on your eye. The pelvic lining and the pelvic organs slide smoothly across each other, but endometriosis acts like sand or sandpaper. And so even a tiny bit of endometriosis in a very sensitive spot on top of a nerve or on a sensitive portion of the pelvis can be very, very uncomfortable. There's three real classic symptoms for endometriosis. The first we call dysmenorrhea, which is painful menstrual cramps. Often endometriosis patients will have a history of severe primary dysmenorrhea, which means when you first start your cycle as a young woman, you're the patient who had severe debilitating cramps. How would you compare yours to someone else? There's no way to really know because you've only had your own cramps. The second is dyschezia, which is painful bowel movements. And women with endometriosis, particularly advanced stage endometriosis, may have a lot of cramping and pain that seems almost menstrual in nature when they have bowel movements. The last is a term called dyspareunia, which means painful sex. And that's one of the hallmarks of endometriosis that many patients will suffer for, and it may affect interpersonal relationships and affect someone's self-esteem because they're having so much discomfort with something that the popular media shows shouldn't be that way. A great question is how long endometriosis can go undiagnosed, and the answer can be an entire lifetime. And often it's very symptomatic in what we call the pediatric, adolescent, and young adult age, which is onset of menses up to age 25. The classic patient presentation is probably in the mid-20s to mid-30s. And for most of our infertility patients that present and ultimately have endometriosis, it's whenever they try to achieve pregnancy and are unable to do so. There is a misconception that anyone who has endometriosis will never be able to have children. That is absolutely wrong. Most women with endometriosis will be able to have children and as many children as they want, particularly in the early stages. The more advanced stages, for example, stage 4 endometriosis, which may destroy and club the fallopian tubes, the higher that chance of a patient needing in vitro fertilization or assisted reproductive technology. The second big myth is that unless I have severe pain, I couldn't have endometriosis. And that's not true. Again, based on the different stages, the pain may be severe or minimal based on where the endometriosis occurs. Conversely, just because someone has severe pain in the pelvis doesn't mean they have endometriosis. There are many other causes of pelvic pain, and in our Women's Health Institute here, we deal with many of the other causes of pelvic pain besides endometriosis. So part of our goal and our role is to sort out which of the patients are involved with endometriosis and how can we best help them. One of the things that we're trying to do here at the Women's Health Institute is to bring an awareness about endometriosis to patients. Many patients can look at the clues towards endometriosis and get a suspicion that they may have endometriosis, but they're not sure what they should do with that or where they should go with that. We always ask them to talk to their OBGYN provider about that. If they're still uncertain or if their provider thinks that they may significantly have an effect with endometriosis, then finding someone in the area who is expert in treating the endometriosis can be very important, as our goal as minimally invasive gynecologic surgeons is to try to get the endometriosis treated at the first surgery. The gold standard is laparoscopic surgery. This can be done with laparoscopic instruments or with robotic-assisted laparoscopic instruments, but the key is to try to have excision of all the endometriosis that's found in the pelvis. That goes a long way towards minimizing the need for future surgery and for helping a patient return to a normal lifestyle. Our idea is to use what's called ERAS, Enhanced Recovery After Surgery principles, to allow patients to resume the normal lifestyle as quick as possible. Many of our patients are back jogging 1 or 2 days after their surgery, doing their full workout routine, their yoga, their Pilates, and those are all things that we really endorse.